had an idea to tell a mother-daughter story where the one-line idea was that the mother and daughter want to set the daughter's marriage straight. They wanted to change the husband, who's not a perfect husband. I always wanted to talk about the message of violence against women. I wanted to tell it as a dark comedy. I approached Red Chillies with the script and we went to Alia. And Alia connected with it. She also came in as a producer.
I think Darlings picked me as its first film to be produced. It was a very big decision to make, to be like, what is going to be your first film to produce and all of that. But it happened very naturally and very casually.
I absolutely loved the script, but I didn't like the part.
It's super entertaining and brilliant.
I fell in love with it and there was no going back from there.
So the film is based in Baikala in Mumbai. People in Bombay, because we, I think, all dream big and sometimes wo nahi hota hai. And I think all four characters represent that. So Alia's character is Badrunissa. She is in love with her husband Hamza. The marriage is going wrong, but she has so much hopes that he will change. Hamza, on the other hand, he genuinely loves Badru, but he feels like he's entitled to be dominating and abusive towards her. Shamshunissa is a protective mother. She is obsessed with her daughter's happiness. She believes that men like Hamza can never ever change. She believes that her daughter should just leave him. So Zulfi Bichara, he wants to become a writer, but he didn't succeed. And now he's selling secondhand goods to these women. And these women bully him all the time. And he has a real soft corner for them. And he really wants them to be happy. Baikala has this cosmolingu of Urdu, English, Hindi and Marathi. We started writing dialogues and in first few scenes, there are a lot of S's that we kept adding and it started developing so beautifully. Now this lingo is mostly for Badru.
So Badru has this thing of like adding an S to every English word she knows. She won't say sad, she'll say sads. She won't say thank you, she'll say thanks you. The title has an S to it, Darlings. So we thought it'll be a fun thing to carry through the film.
Every time there was a funny scene, we would just crack up. I think which is fab for the film.
Shamshu, my favorite character in the film. Even when I heard the narration, I was like, oh my god, who's gonna play this character? Because it's so important and so important for the film. Enter Chef Ali Shah.
Ali and me are working together for the first time, and I think we have great chemistry.
Vijay, he's extremely professional, considering he had to be tied up a lot and really tortured, and he was really not very comfortable with most of the film. He was a total sport.
There's a great deal of regard that I have for Alia as an artist. I've never worked with anybody who comes with this kind of an insight about the story, about the character.
Alia, Chef Ali and Vijay, all three of them, I've seen their work already and I really like their work.
Roshan was one of my favourite characters, again on paper, Zulfi. He's such a sweet, innocent boy who's trying to help but he's stuck between these two mad women.
These actors are fab, not just Alia, Chef, Vijay and Roshan, but everybody else. I think I got my dream cast, so I'm very happy.
Working with Jasmeet is sheer delight. I don't know. I've never seen her lose her cool.
She gets the job done. She stays very focused and all of those qualities I really like.
She has an insight of the relationships of the characters and she's open to your ideas and suggestions.
So she really is very good with making the moment come to life with all these real details. I think she's done an extremely special job and this is just the beginning for her.
See, I think every film should say something. Every film should have something important to say. This film did. And if you can tell it in an engaging, entertaining way and not preach, I think that's the best way to tell a story.
Got it! take one.